my hands on myself. Pick up, dust them off, put them back up on the shelf. Kiss my little baby girl is in me. Am I coming out of left field? Hi guys, welcome to this new video about the Japalura and another RunCam Split. Today it's gonna be the following of a previous video I did a few months ago about how I put the RunCam Split in my Japalura. So now that the RunCam Split 2 has been released, of course I want to do another video with the Split 2 in the Japalura. I know some of you asked me the first time how I put my Split in the Japalura in a way I didn't have the frame in shot. So I'm going to show you while I dismounted how it was mounted, because it's a little trick, really easy to do, but then you don't have the frame in shot and it's really convenient. And then after that I will install the Split 2 in it and we'll try it in this area. It's a bando we discovered yesterday, and as we don't have any workbench at home, we were like, oh, this is perfect. So yeah, new video in a bando, we'll see how it goes. Sorry if I look stressed, but there's a rat right here. I don't know where it is, that's the worst part. But yeah, so for those who don't know, what is a RunCam Split? It's actually a combination of an HD camera and an FPV camera. So it's called Split because obviously it's in two parts. And you can add an SD card in this board and it will record your flight in HD. At the same time, you can see the feed in your goggles. So yeah, that was just for the reminder of what a Split is. So now that I'm going to dismount the Split, I'm going to show you what I dismounted, how it was mounted, so you can do it as well in your Japalura. Okay, so all you have to do to avoid having the frame in the shot when you put your camera in the Japalura is turning upside down the mount of the camera that you fix with this screw to the camera. And then you can put the camera in the frame using this threading in this hole. So this way the camera will move forward instead of being inside the frame, and the lens will be right at the edge of the frame and you won't see it in your shot. Okay, so now it's going to be an easy step to put this camera in the Japalura. I'm just going to put this camera in the mount and then I'm going to replace the previous board with the new one. The only difference between the old and the newborn is there was a plug on the board of the Split one and now they replaced it with soldering pads. The last thing you need to know about the new camera is that it has a voltage range from 5 volt to 17 volt, whereas the first one was only 5 volt. But for me it's not going to change anything. I'm just going to solder these wires on these pads and we should be good to go. Am I coming out of left field? Ooh, I'm a rebel just for kicks. I've been feeling it since 1966. Happy over now, but I feel it. So because a lot of people didn't like the old system to put the SD card in the Split, they changed it in the Split 2. So now instead of a little door that's a little bit tricky to open, you just have one slot in which you can push your card, take it out, and then push it again, and then it stays in place. And to be sure you don't lose the SD card, they give you this plate that you put on the board, and then you should keep the SD card in place. There's one more thing I need to tell you before I put the camera in the frame. As you can see, this antenna is pretty damaged, so I'm going to remove it and remove the whole system, including the SMR pigtail, and I'm gonna replace it with this Actuna V-Race, which has been sent by, and I'm really sorry if I pronounce your name wrong, Wojciech Repinski. So I'm gonna write it so I'm sure you guys know the name of this nice person who sent me two samples, actually with different lengths. So I'm gonna see which one I'm gonna use because I don't know yet, but thanks a lot for sending me these antennas and I'm gonna test them today. As you can see, it's finished. It looks pretty nice. We're gonna try it soon. I'm using Dal Prop's 3045 on it. I used to have the HQ Prop's 3x3x3, and I also had before that KviN, but I asked Dal Prop's if I could try this one, so we're gonna see how it goes today with these props, and yeah, let's do it.
my hands on myself. Pick up, dust them off, put them back up on the shelf. Kiss my little baby girl, is it me? Am I coming out of left field? Ooh, I'm a rebel just for kicks. I've been feeling it since 1966.
Time to give a conclusion to this episode. Yep. So, like you saw, it's really easy to install if you already had the split in it. It's really easy to swap. If you didn't, I hope I was clear enough. I mean, more than last time, to explain how to put the camera in it so you don't see the frame and all these things. If not, you can always ask me questions. I'm happy to answer. But apart from that, with the split, what do you think?
Well, I think it's if people didn't buy the split one first and they get the split two, I think it's a good move because the voltage input you can provide to the split 2 is actually the range is wider than on the split 1. Split 1 was like 5 volt and that was it. With the split 2 it's 5 to 17 volts, so that's a big improvement.
Apart from that, in the previous version we had a blue flash when we were flying. You can probably still notice a little bit in the video.
In the previous video about the split 1, you could see some blue flashes that was completely random. We thought we solved the problem by replacing the voltage regulator, but it wasn't the case really. We're not sure what happened, but anyways, on this one, no blue flashes. So
That's a good improvement too. Antenna?
The antenna reception was great.
Like,
we are in a bando, it's not the best place for reception. With this antenna, it was really, really good. So we can't complain about that. It's actually pretty good.
So pretty much, I'm really happy with the split 2. Thanks, RunCam, for giving it to me so I could try it. I don't regret it at all. And I hope you guys enjoy the footage. I hope it gives you the idea to do it as well. If you do it, we'll be happy to see pictures of your build. That's it for today. Thanks for watching. See you next time.